Simple pneumatic actuator valves will either be fully closed or fully open. There is no option to open or close these valves in percentage. For example, if we want to regulate the flow of the water and want to open this valve by 50%, there is no option with this valve. It will be fully closed or it will be fully open. To control the flow of the liquid, we need a more advanced control valve. Welcome to another training session. In today's session, we will discuss what is a control valve and how does it work. If you want to learn about industrial automation, do consider subscribing this channel and press the bell icon for more upcoming video tutorials. A control valve is a power-operated device used to regulate or manipulate the flow of fluids, such as gas, oil, water, and steam. It is a critical part of a control loop, and it is an example of a final control element. The control valve is by far the most common final control element used in industry today. A control valve can be operated electrically, pneumatically, or hydraulically. A control valve receives a signal from a controller, for example from a PLC, in order for it to move, resulting in a change in flow rate. A control valve has two separate components: the valve and the actuator. The actuator is the device connected to the valve through the valve stem that provides the force required to move the valve. As we said earlier, the actuator can be controlled electrically, pneumatically, or hydraulically. The most common and the most reliable is the pneumatic actuator. The control valve receives a signal from a controller. In order to operate, the controller compares the actual flow rate to the desired flow value, called the set point. The controller will produce an output to move the valve and bring the flow rate to the set point value. Because the PLC signal is electrical, most common signal type is 4 to 20 milliamperes. The control valve may require a device to convert that electrical signal into a pneumatic force so that it can operate. An IP converter, which is a current to pressure converter, will convert electrical signal into pneumatic force. This compressed air gets filled inside the diaphragm, and valve stem moves upwards, and valve opens up. When this air is released partially, the valve stem moves down under the spring tension, the valve slowly closes. These valves can be opened in percentage by controlling the air pressure in the diaphragm to achieve any desired flow rate of the liquid through the valve. Because of how pneumatic actuators are built, a control valve will move to a specific position when a loss of the control signal occurs. As the supply air pressure is increased, the rubber diaphragm pushes against the spring and moves the valve stem upward out of the valve body. As the supply air pressure is reduced, the spring will move the valve stem inside the valve body. The position to which the control valve is moved, if a loss of signal occurs, is referred to as the failsafe mode. The type of failsafe mode depends on the application for which the control valve is used. The actuator causes the valve to close. In a fail-closed control valve, and the actuator causes the valve to open, in a fail-open control valve. I hope you liked today's video. If you want to learn about industrial automation, do consider subscribing this channel and press the bell icon for more upcoming video tutorials. Till next time, take care, and goodbye.